HPH Hospice has been accepted by the National Hospice Palliative Care Organization and the Department of Veteran Affairs as a partnering agency in their We Honor Veterans program. We believe America's veterans have done everything asked of them in their mission to serve our country, and it is our privilege to serve their unique needs and challenges at the end of life.
I want to thank HPH Hospice for this certificate and all the personnel that works for HPH. I want to thank them all.
Done for me everything. They've done everything. They're the best outfit in the world. I haven't found a bad person in Hospice. I haven't found a... Every one of them has been.
Partnering with the Marine Corps League Auxiliary Unit number 137 in Spring Hill, HPH Hospice recently introduced a new component to its We Honor Veterans pinning ceremonies titled Stars for Troops. In addition to a certificate and a pin, each veteran patient now receives a star from a worn American flag with a message that reads, "I am part of our American flag that has flown over a home in Florida. I can no longer fly. The sun and wind have caused me to become tattered and torn. Please carry me as a reminder that you are not forgotten."
Pinning ceremony is extremely meaningful to the patients and their families. That piece of it, just honoring them, I believe for a lot of the patients and their families is something they haven't necessarily had a lot of, depending on the war they were in. Many of the patients have never really talked about their experiences. I've had patients say to me, "I've never talked to anyone about what happened over there," and they seem to get a lot of relief from it.
Each day is a gift, and hospice care allows veterans and their families to make the most of the time they have together. We believe in supporting the entire family unit and provide services ranging from caregiver instruction to bereavement counseling.
Ceremony at the Veterans Program because my dad was probably the first unofficial person that was honored 2 years ago before we recently took this on as a major undertaking with the volunteers. And I know what it meant to me and my father, and I knew that I wanted to be part of this program and honor the men who served our country as well.
There's a lot of different ways to honor veterans, and I'm always very pleased when I see how hospice teams pin veterans or present them with a certificate or something that acknowledges their service and their sacrifices. I think beyond that, however, is something that's very important, and that is that pinning service or that acknowledgement service, however it is done, becomes a passageway into stories. It often precipitates their military stories. The other thing I think is very important is it's very important sometimes for their families to hear these stories commonly, I will have family members say, gee, I've never heard that. He's never told that story. We didn't know that. So it's really that last opportunity before they die to be able to do
that. Families can be a great source of comfort for patients, but there's something special about the connection between veterans. Many of our staff and volunteers served in the armed forces, and they consider it a sacred duty to care for fellow veterans.
A few months ago, a Marine veteran who had been in Vietnam had a lot of walls built up, wouldn't hardly talk to anybody. And as a Marine talking to a Marine, I went in and I did the ceremony, the appreciation ceremony for him that we do. And everything was fine. He kept the wall up until I stood back and saluted him. And it's like he just broke down and began to, I guess the nice way is pour out his life to me. And in that, I saw healing take place. I just saw almost some supernatural things as he was able to vent some of the things that had been pent up in him for a long, long time.
The one Saturday night, it was a very last minute pinning. And she was the first lieutenant. And she was part of the Vietnam era. And she wound up at Walter Reed Hospital taking care of the wounded vets. When I walked into the room, it was only her husband that was there. And I asked him if she was asleep, and he said, well, yes. And she kind of drifts in and out. She had an oxygen mask on. So I asked him for permission to proceed with our ceremony, and he said, of course. And I called her by name. And after the pinning, I presented her husband with the certificate and the star that comes off the American flag. And I grabbed her hand, and I was holding her hand. And I said to her, welcome home, sister. The next thing I know, she squeezed my hand so hard, I knew she heard me. And I also didn't realize that her husband was a veteran, and he stood up from his chair. He stood back and he saluted me. And I almost lost it. I almost did. And he looked at me and said, it's okay. Meanwhile, I'm still holding her hand and she's still squeezing it. To describe it, you can't. You have to feel it. And I did.
I come from a family where my father was a veteran during World War II. My husband was a veteran during Vietnam, and my two sons served during the Persian Gulf and Afghanistan. And I know how it feels just to have somebody come up and say to them, thank you for giving all that you did for our country to make it what it is today. And it's an honor to be able to give tribute to these people.
In addition to honoring patients, the We Honor Veterans program honors HPH Hospice staff and volunteers who have served in the armed forces.